Hello everyone, I am Neha Shukla and I am here to discuss a concept called market segmentation. Market segmentation is a process of dividing distinct buyers according to their distinct needs, characteristics and similar or different marketing mixes that they require. We can also say in simple terms, market segmentation is a process of dividing markets into different segments. Market segment, I would like to also define market segment, which says market segment is a group of buyers with similar who respond in a similar way to a given set of marketing mixes. There are four variables according to which a market can be divided or segmented. They are geographic, demographic, psychographic and behavioral. First, I would like to discuss about geographic segmentation. In geographical segmentation, we divide the market into different geographic units according to various factors such as neighborhoods, cities, states and countries. In nowadays, many companies have started localizing their products according to the needs of the cities, states, neighborhoods and countries. One of the examples of such segmentation is the version of Resident Evil series done by a company called Capcom. They are selling the series of Resident Evil as Biohazard in countries like Japan and France. So they are doing the geographic segmentation. The other way of segmenting a market is demographic. We can also segment a market according to its demographics, such as life cycle stage, gender, income, education, generation, nationality, or community. While we are doing demographic segmentation, the major factor that we consider is life cycle stage, gender, income and education. Life cycle stage, I would like to give an example of Leo Toys, which designs toys for small children according to different age groups. Like it design the what toys it designs for a 4-year-old, it does not designs for a 12-year-old. Because they believe that psyche of a 4-year-old will be different from that child of 12-year-old. So they design products accordingly. I would also like to discuss the example of HDFC Standard Life Insurance. They always go for, most of all, focus on pension schemes targeting the adult audience. So that is also an example of life cycle stage segmentation. Then I would like to discuss about gender segmentation, gender part of demographic segmentation. That we can see in Fair and Handsome Cream. They actually categorize the product into males and females. So they are categorizing the product, they are defining their segments according to the gender characteristics of market. Then we come to income characteristic of demographic segmentation. While dividing the market into various segments according to their income, like we can take the examples of BMW, Mercedes, Audi. They always target a segment which is of premium class. While there are some stores like Big Bazaar which say isse sasta aur nahi aur kahin nahi. They basically say target price sensitive customers. So a market can be segmented according to income also. Then I would like to discuss these factors like education, generation, nationality, which actually tells about the standards and the psyche of the segment we are targeting, like how much qualification they have, what cultural psyche and characteristics they have. Then I would like to discuss another variable in market segmentation, which is psychographic. Psychographic segmentation can be according to social class, lifestyle or personality characteristics of a person. There are many examples of companies which track the human psyche or kind of social class, lifestyle or personality of a person. So such as there is a company called Talco in Pakistan. Whose name depicts strong power. That is actually a tree brand. So they basically target a characteristic of a particular segment which prefers having a strong tea, a strong flavor in tea. So they clearly observe lifestyle lifestyle, personality and social class of a people, which gives a view about the psychographics of a particular market segment, and they divide their market according to that. Then we also come to the next variable by which we can divide market segment, which is behavioral segment. We can divide a market segment through behavioral characteristics while considering occasions, benefit sort, user status and loyalty status of our target market. While coming to occasions, a company divides or decides its market segment according to occasions, such as we see Cadbury celebrations. Cadbury launches its various packages during festivities, during Valentine's Day. Many greeting cards even come during the festivities. So that is dividing the market according to behavior or occasion. Like Cadbury says, Raksha Bandhan, they depict in their advertisement itself that their packaging is specially for various occasions such as Raksha Bandhan, Diwali or something. Then we can also divide the market according to benefits sought. While dividing the market segment, we consider many people like value-seeking moms. When we consider our moms, what do they seek in a product? They seek durability. It should be usable for all. So that is their behavior of value-seeking mom. They actually seek value. While when we come to teenagers, what we see is fit and polish. Today's teens, they actually look for a product which would give them fashion and style and should be as trendy and affordable as it could be. So it should fit and polish themselves. So that also comes in benefit sort. Different people seek different benefits in a product. So a company can target its product according to the benefits sought by the buyer. They may be moms, value-seeking moms or fit and polished teenagers. The other factor we can take is user status. Company can also divide its market according to its user status. A company divides a user status, a market according to user status by considering four factors. There they may have non-users, existing users, potential users and regular users. A company needs to attract and develop products that could attract non-users, retain its present or regular users, also should attract the potential users and ex-users could also come back to their product and seek value in their product. So a company can also divide their market according to this particular factor. Then a company can also divide its products according to loyalty status of their buyers, such as Colgate. It is a hardcore brand loyal product. Some consumers may also be loyal for stores such as Big Bazaar. Some people prefer only buying from Shoppers Stop or Walmart because they believe that it's quite compatible to their needs. So the market can also be divided according to loyalty status. Some companies can also go for intermarket segmentation. They multiple segmentation strategy, I should say. They do not consider any one of the variables, but they consider all the variables and go for various strategic and different kind of marketing mixes. For example, Coca-Cola. It goes for various kind of marketing segmentation, be it geographic, demographics. They try to innovate their products like Pepsi, like Coke. According to the needs of the people. They define packages according to the needs of people. They look for geographic segmentation according to the needs of the people. And this basically considers a kind of a blend of various sort of variables which are involved in marketing segmentation. Then a business market can also segment a business market. A business market can be divided into a merchant, corporate, or a business or a special business user. For example, ICICI Bank, it has its cards for merchants, which is a merchant card, then corporations, which is a corporate card. It may also design its product, which is an app card, according to the needs of the small and medium sized enterprises. international markets can also be divided. I can give you the examples Coca-Cola or Lexus. Lexus is a range of furniture which are sold among the various geographic units, and they also consider the factors like what their consumer actually needs, and they tailor their products according to their needs. So there are various ways to segment international market also. While dividing the market, the international market, we take four to five factors into consideration, which may be economic factors, cultural factors, political legal factors, geographic factors, and demographic factors. So these factors are considered, and exceptions are always there. Sometimes, like the neighborhood countries, I can talk about UK and Canada. They mostly prefer, it's a kind of same kind of a cultural environment between them. But a country neighboring to them called Mexico has a different set of sci-fi and a different set of sci-fi, which needs a different kind of segmentation. So that is also a way to segment the international market. But how can a market segment be effective? A market segment can be affected by considering five factors only. Our market segmentation should be effective, it should be substantial, it should be measurable, it should be differentiable, and it should be actionable. It should be measurable, that means the company or the product maker, the seller, should be able to measure the needs of the people. It should be substantial, it should contain materialistic stuff, what a buyer needs and what are his needs and wants, and so on. So these are basically five factors which a person needs to consider while segmenting a market. Thank you.